Arbern, we're here at the Independent Filmmakers Lounge. This is Utah Technology Magazine, and we are interviewing a few guests here today. It's Saturday, day two of the film festival, and sitting next to me is
Dion Mariani.
Dion Mariani, where are you from, Dion?
I'm from Cape Cod, Massachusetts.
Okay, and why are you here?
I'm here for a movie premiere, actually.
Okay, and what movie premiere is that?
The name of it's Under the Electric Sky. It's due to premiere Saturday, midnight premiere on the 18th.
Okay.
And it's a feature documentary about a festival, Electric Daisy Carnival Las Vegas, and my friends and I experience traveling to the festival and our journey there across country.
Okay, now tell me, it's a documentary then?
It is a documentary.
Okay, and then who was it written by?
It wasn't written by anyone. It was a reality-based documentary.
Okay.
Followed us around from Cape Cod, Massachusetts to Las Vegas, and it just pretty much just chronicled our experiences and our journey from one side of the country to the other and our experience throughout the music festival.
Oh, wow. And how long did it take you to do?
Well, we kind of had to book it across country, you know, a little last minute. So I'd say we drove through in like 3 days, just nonstop.
Oh, really? Three
and
days?
The festival's another 3 days. So it was about like 7 days of filming straight, you know?
That's all, huh?
I mean, it was like 24
hours a
day. I mean,
I should say
day,
that's
though.
All.
I mean, you get a
okay.
camera crew for a week straight. You tell me if that's all.
I'm sorry. That's funny. So when was it completed?
The festival happens every year towards the end of June. So
now you're talking about, okay, well, we're talking about two different festivals here.
No, one festival.
Okay, you're talking about the festival. Wait, you said something about Las Vegas. Okay.
It's in Las Vegas.
But people might think we're talking about the Sundance Film Festival.
All right. Okay, well, let's be specific here.
Right.
Electric Daisy Carnival is the festival we went to.
Okay, that's a different festival in Las
Vegas. It's a
different
festival. We're at Sundance here.
Right, and
we were at EDC, as you would like call it.
Right.
Well, yeah, it chronicled our journey from in the summer, end of June, all the way to Las Vegas. And it was.
And what is it? What is it about again? It's called
It's called Under the Electric Sky.
Okay, Under the Electric Sky.
And it's about the production of the festival, the artists, the experience the festival goers have.
Okay.
And just the love and the experience they go throughout their
oh,
journey.
Oh wow, interesting. It's a documentary, and it took 7 days or so.
For us, there was a couple groups that were filmed.
Right.
We were one of them, and our journey. We drove across country from Cape Cod, Massachusetts. So it's a little pretty much polar opposites, coast to coast. And
did you drive in a bus together?
RV. Or? We actually took an RV.
Okay,
seven of my best
RV.
Friends. Six of my best friends and myself.
Okay.
Yeah.
And who came up with this idea?
Well, they EDC held auditions, audition tapes in.
Okay.
And so we were chosen, selected out of a bunch of people, and as one of, I think, maybe five groups or so or whatnot. And we got to be filmed and chosen to go to this festival and enjoy the experience.
So when did you guys submit to the, did you guys think about submitting here
we
to
submitted,
Sundance?
I want to say, in end of April.
Okay.
April, a dear friend of mine.
And under the documentary category, is that
yes,
correct?
Yes, absolutely. Okay. Oh, submitted to Sundance or submitted
to
the film?
Submitted here to
submitted the film. I believe it was last minute, actually.
Because some of them are.
When's the cutoff? January, I believe?
Yeah, but some of them are last minute. And you don't know if you're admitted
I think
until.
I think it was they submitted last minute, like December, actually.
Okay.
I thought you meant how to submit an audition tape to the film.
Oh, no.
But yeah, I believe December was submitted to Sundance. And
yeah.
It got chosen to premiere on Saturday at midnight. So it's a big slot,
Yeah.
It's very exciting.
That
tomorrow.
Is exciting. That's tomorrow. When is it tomorrow? Where?
Tomorrow at midnight at the Library Theater.
And that's in Park City?
It is Park City.
Okay.
It's right on Park Ave.
Because a lot of people don't know that they also premiere sometimes in Salt Lake.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
This is my first time to Sundance, and I mean, what an experience to be able to go see myself. I'm losing my mind. You're lucky I'm keeping my composure right now. Usually I'd be getting.
I'm trying to calm him down.
Crazy right now.
But that's funny.
It's a great experience. I mean, I've been here for about a day and a half, and already, just the people I've met. Monica yourself, very nice, very nice looking.
Well, thank you very much.
You're
I just
welcome.
Had my makeup done in there.
I saw. I was checking you out.
You were checking. Because at the end of the day, you do get the tired look. So you need a little
bit
of white
hair. Well, we
all
get that look. Trust me. After 5 days of filming in Las Vegas, I know all about the tired look.
So now, tell me, did you like Las Vegas? Have you ever been to Las Vegas?
I have been. I grew up in Los Angeles, so
okay.
I had been a couple times as a younger.
But you came here from
Cape Cod, Massachusetts.
Okay. But
yeah, so I had to go to. I had to move to Massachusetts to get back on the big screen in Hollywood.
Okay. So tell us about growing up in L.A.
Growing up in Los Angeles.
Did you ever want to be a movie star?
Absolutely.
Did you? Okay.
I mean, I'm an actor as well, so this is why I came here. This is like a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity, not only to experience seeing a movie that I was a part of in a project, but also I've never been to Sundance Film Festival. I mean,
right.
It's one of the most prominent festivals in the country.
You know, it's interesting because we just interviewed a gentleman yesterday. He and we already had the interview scheduled, in fact, and he just got, yesterday morning, we had the interview scheduled for the evening,
mm-hmm.
And the morning he got an Oscar nomination. So maybe we'll give you some good luck.
Who knows?
Who knows?
Cheers to that right
that's
there.
Right.
There we go. Sundance
you
Wish.
Never,
you never
that's
know.
Right.
Who knows? Best
good
documentary
luck.
Could be there, you know?
I know. Okay, so then, so how long is the documentary?
Documentary is, I believe, 90, 95 minutes long, about an hour and a half.
Okay.
And I actually haven't, this is my first time seeing it. Tomorrow night will be the first cut.
Oh, really? So you haven't seen the cut at all?
This is, you and I both would be surprised.
Did you ever see the footage or anything?
No. I mean, my own cell phone footage of us, our experience.
Oh,
I've
wow.
But yeah, as far as the final cut, this is
this
what
is
I'm
for you.
To see it.
Oh,
yeah.
That's exciting. That's
yeah, I might not be able to keep my composure in the theater.
Oh, I know. I know it's exciting. I mean, it's an emotional thing making a movie.
It is. Especially
people
it's dedicated
realize
to my, our close friend. And so, like, I just really hope we pay tribute to him the right way.
Okay, you know? Now tell me about the close friend. Is he in the movie? Is he in the storyline?
Yeah, he's in the storyline. I mean, my group of friends, were called we call ourselves the Wolf Pack. And
okay.
It's something that kind of coincidental that we're going to Las Vegas as the Wolf Pack. Well, we were the original Wolf Pack before that hangover nonsense. But our leader of our Wolf Pack, our alpha male, Michael Ferris, is his
a younger,
more attractive, more spontaneous, whatever you want to call it, Wolf Pack. He was like the leader of our pack, and he passed away in April, and that was
he
was 24.
And if you mind,
3 days before his 25th birthday.
Why and how, if you don't mind me asking?
It was an unfortunate accident that happened when he was in Florida, and it was a shame. But I mean,
is he part of the documentary?
It's not. The film is actually a tribute and a dedication
to
him.
Okay.
So
okay.
He is part of it, you know.
Yeah, in spirit. That's right.
And we were saying it the entire time of filming, like, listen, we know you guys, like, you think you guys chose us for our personality, or whatever, but no, Ferris, our friend Ferris, he made this happen. We were convinced the entire time. It was actually pretty, I don't even know, emotional. On the plane right over here last night, a woman was sitting next to me, and she was like, her kid was crying, and the babysitter was behind her. So I offered to switch my seat out, you know, go ahead, sit with your children. And I sit that next down to this woman, and the first thing she pulls out, she goes, what are you doing? I was like, I'm going to Sundance Film Festival. And she tells me, she goes, okay, well, what are you doing? I'm like, I have a movie there, you know, tell her about my Wolf Pack. And as soon as I said, it's dedicated to my friend, Michael Ferris, she goes, oh, pulls out a bag of nuts from Cincinnati, Ohio, where we were flying out of, and the brand of the nuts was Ferris. I kid you not.
Really?
And I took a picture of it. I like almost teared up. I was like, this is gonna be a good weekend.
Oh, wow.
And it was a full moon, so.
Yeah, full moon. Things, good things. You know,
Wolfpack. That's you better believe it. You know, we howling at the moon.
That's right, Wolfpack.
It was. I looked out the window. I saw the full moon. I saw our nuts, and I didn't even want any nuts. I was full. I was like, give me some of those nuts. Let me have some. Ferris was telling me to try them.
That's funny. That's very funny. So his name is Ferris. That's his
Michael Ferris. Yeah,
Michael
Ferris.
Okay, that's fascinating. And so, okay? First of all, do you have an agent?
I do not have an agent.
You do not have an agent. Okay, you never know. We'll see what you need.
Maybe my 5 days here at Sundance.
Things might happen.
You know?
So now, what's next for you?
What's next? I mean, after I enjoy this whole experience and savor it and take it in, I think I'm gonna have to move back to the West Coast where I belong.
Yeah.
You know, especially then get my foot in the door. I do miss home. I mean, I'm not for this cold weather.
Oh no!
I am not for this cold weather. Like,
it's not that cold.
See, that's what I'm saying. I'm not. This is like me being
but
a supermodel.
I'm from California.
Like, this is too cold for me. Okay?
It is. That's cold. Okay.
It is way too cold. See, we got people
that's
telling
funny.
Us it's cold. It's definitely cold.
That's fine. It is cold. I mean,
I grew up in California sunshine.
Yeah.
So.
Well, you're Southern Cal, right?
Los Angeles, North Hollywood.
Okay, North Hollywood. Well,
I moved to Boston when I was or Cape Cod when I was 15.
Okay.
So I got
you're
the best and worst of both sides.
Yeah, but no, but that's pretty cool because you know there's something about the East Coast that is very real. People that are there are very real.
I mean, it definitely.
I mean, they're ruthlessly real.
Yes.
And I like it.
Believe it
or not. I've been in New York, and you know the people are just like, you know, they just tell you how it is.
Well, New York's
you know?
A whole different entity in itself.
It's
but
a
I mean,
whole
the East Coast,
planet.
Especially women. I mean, no offense, no
I don't
know.
I don't either. I think
but
it's refreshingly
you speak to a woman
rude,
in California,
you know, and it's nice.
Or New England, like she will tell you straight up, get out of my face. Like I don't want to talk to you. Girls in Cali, whatever, you know, like, you know, they do their thing. But girls, you can't really BS around these girls in New England.
Oh no, they can see right through you, and they ain't got
they're
time.
Diehard sports fans too. Like I like
they'll
sports, but these
down.
Girls, jeez, they know more than me. I like watching sports. They're like. Yeah, who's your like fantasy football team? I'm like, I don't.
I know. They're like, get out of here.
Yeah, exactly. That's pretty ridiculous.
Oh well, that's so fun to meet you and
pleasure.
Nice to talk to you, and good luck again. Tell us the film and your
Under
name.
Under the Electric Sky
name.
Premieres tomorrow, Saturday the 18th at midnight, and my name's Dion Mariani.
So
keep
look
an
for
eye
that
out.
Name. That's looking at look out for Dion Mariani. Thank you so much for joining us, folks. Monica Barber with Utah Technology Magazine, recording live from the Independent Filmmakers Lounge. And join us, download our app, the magazine, actually, on the app store. Yeah, we have a magazine. So And also on YouTube. We'll have this on YouTube in the next couple
Fabulous.
Of days.
Fabulous. YouTube sensation.
On the YouTube